Welcome back, class. We are live. It is 9:32 a.m. October 25th. And period two, CAD and robotics. So this is a CAD assignment, introduction to assembly design. And our activity involves mating these parts together to create this assembly. So let's proceed. And just get my face out of there. All right, so the first thing to do is to make a copy of this particular Onshape file. And once you do that, then you proceed and create an assembly. And so I've done all that here. So I've got the joint, and then I created an assembly for the joint, which is here. So that's our goal, is to start there based on the instructions. And so once you create this assembly, you now follow these directions here at the bottom. You see that? And you insert you fix the object, you insert these parts, and proceed. And so that's going to be my goal, is to follow these directions step by step, piece by piece, okay? So let's give it a shot. So I'm going to take a look. I've got the universal joint, and I want to create an assembly. And then I'm going to insert that joint into the assembly and fix it at the mate, at the origin, okay? So let's see where I'm at. So I've got the universal joint, which is here. Alrighty, there's that universal joint. I'm now gonna assemble it here. Insert. So first step, find the part. I've got a couple other items here as well that I can ignore, but here it is, universal joint. There it is. It's accepted. You'll notice that it looks like it's attached here at the origin when it inserted. If it didn't, you can attach it to the origin with a simple right click and fix to or attach to origin or move to origin. What I'm doing here now is I'm going to take this and fix it. And if you don't remember how to do that, you just take a peek at the set of directions. I think it was step four. And you choose the part and then choose fix. And it might be tough to see that on the video, but you pop open the document to see it more clearly. So the part is here. Right click, choose fix. And there you have it. So that now is totally locked there. It's not movable. So if I click on it now, you notice you don't get the triad. That X, Y, Z triad that allows you to move the object, just not there anymore. And so based on the instructions, you go to step five, and now we're going to take this universal joint component here and insert that. And once we insert that, again, you want to choose the component. Otherwise, it's good. If you insert these individual parts, you got to do one at a time. You don't want to do that. Once you insert those, then you want to take the center block first and attach it to the center mate connector using the Revolute. So here we go. Bless you. Let's go to insert. And let's just click on this drop down. You see all the individual components. Let's choose all of the components. And there you have it. Now, I'm going to give it some space. Let me pause the video here real quick.
Sorry for the interruption.
All right. Sorry for the interruption. So I'm going to choose my spot there and green check mark. So looking at this, this is the block I want to insert here. It has a mate connector already established. Actually, a couple of them. See them? So you want to choose the mate connector that has the same orientation as this one in the U-joint area, this block. And so I see the blue Z-axis in that direction to the right. So I'm going to mate to this connector that's also to the right. I believe it's on this side. That one's facing toward me, but it's the other one. We'll use a revolute, which is this option. So my first step is to select the block. So I'm going to rotate around this way. I want to choose this mate connector right there. Click it. Now I want to choose this mate connector here. And there you go. Perfect. Excellent. Let's accept it. Now it still wants to revolute. See it? You can just undo that. I'm not ready to revolute that yet. Actually, we might be. We're actually going to revolute this part here. If you look at your directions. You now take. And you know what, too? I missed it. There's these limits of the revolute. It says the atom, okay? If you scroll down here. Just to add these limits so that it rotates a certain set of degrees. And so go back to your original revolute and create limits. This was negative 90. This is negative 90. And this other one was positive 90. For some reason, this is acting up. There we go. And let's play that animation and see what happens. Perfect. That's what you want. So the set of directions again. It's really important to read. Oops, wrong button. To read the directions. And we were talking to a couple of mechanics, the National Guard, work on helicopters. And the way they do their work is they read the manual step by step by step and follow each set of directions. They don't skip. And that's how they put these devices, these mechanical components together after they remove the parts and replace them. So here's the next step. We'll take this particular component here, and we're going to attach it to kind of like an axle using the mate connector. Okay. Some directions about how to do that. So let's make it happen. Kind of gives you a zoomed in perspective here. And here we go. So. Looks like it's connected here, but it's not, so you can move it. So my first step is to take this object here. Let's find the center. Fasten mate, hover over the plane, hold shift down so that you don't jump around. And it's that here. Now it looks like it wants to freeze there for some reason. Not 100% why it's frozen, but let me fix that here real quick. I'll refresh my browser. Oftentimes, with web-based applications, you kind of have to refresh the browser if something doesn't work correctly. It's probably has to do with the packages being transferred back and forth. Drop them. All right, it's back. So let's zoom in again. Let's try this out. Let's go make connector. It's rigid. Select this option here. Shift. There's the center. Huh, weird. Let's see if I do that. Okay, it did connect there. I usually hold shift down to make that happen, and it didn't have to this time. Not sure why. But now we're choosing this ridge right here. This ridge right there. Make sure you select the right one. I'm gonna hold shift down and zoom back out. Right there it is. Yeah. And it's attached. So if I want to analyze, we just accept this here. If I want to analyze whether it's connected properly or not, I like to do section views. So I'll hover around here. I go to my view queue, section view, just click on the face. Yeah, there we go. So you can tell that it's right. See it? Oops, my bad. Swoop it around this way. I moved it inadvertently. But let's accept that view. You can see, if I right click on that, it can go normal. You can see it's perfectly mated. There isn't any intersections. It's a nice section view. It's mated in the right section. So that's what you want. Let's go back over here, just turn off section view, and let's go back to our okay. So again, let's go back to our assembly. These directions over here. And now part two or part eight. So we're gonna take this, we're gonna mate it to this. And you can see what's expected. You're mating it to the surface of the block at center point, and it's mated to this ring center point. All right. So I'll take this ring. And it's, is it a revolute? Let's see. No, it's fastened. It's not a revolute. Fast. Let's go here. Shift. Click. Yep. And then I hope that's the right spot. We'll find it. And let's go over here. Now, if for some reason it's hard to see what's going on, you know, like this U joint seems like it's in the way. You can always click on the eye and hide it. You see that? It's a great strategy. So that just gives you the ability to see this a little more clearly. And you notice that the orientation of that's backwards. So you can choose this primary axis flip. It flips it around, you see that? And that's the right connection. This portion here is missing, it left behind. And that's okay because you're just analyzing this fit. But to see what it's like after you choose the green check mark, you go to the solve button and it attaches it the way it should be seen. And that's the way it would attach. If you like that, accept it. And now, if you want to do a parts analysis, you can. I don't need this. Fastener 3. Then unhide the universal joint. And now you see it. It's exactly the way it should be. Perfect. Okay? Looks like everything's mated correctly. Again, if you want to do an analysis, not that you have to, go to section view. And then you can move that through the object. See what's going on. right click on that, view to normal, flat. And I like what I see. No overlapping parts. It's perfect. Now, again, poke at the directions. And now here, see what's going on here. It says to select two instances in the instant list to the right. Move to new sub-assembly. All right, so they want us to select the bronze. I don't see what it says. And the universal joint axle. So these two parts. So let's do that. Let's see. I'm going to drag this on this side so I can see it. So it looks like we want to move this part and the joint axle. Let's see. And this part. Yeah, so it's that axle and that other item on the axle. It says move to new assembly. So that must be a right click. And so I don't know if you noticed, but by doing that, it takes these components and it creates a separate item in the list. So you can poke it in the eye and both are gone. See it? Nice. And now we go to section 10. So we want to take this item here. Wait 1 second, let me pause this video one more time. All right, and that's step number 8. When I'm the way I created my folders, you may have not done this, but that particular new sub-assembly that I created, it's actually in a different folder. So if I go to my home button here, there it is, assembly 4. See that? So this is that new assembly that I created. And based on the instructions, they give it a different name. It's been renamed Universal Joint Axle. So I'll rename that too. Rename Universal Joint Axle. So I'm also going to try to move that into the folder that has all of the components. And it says joint. So we take this, drag it in here. Back here, there it is. The other components too, the U-joint, I have them in separate folders. And you could drag them into this. Well, there's the universal joint assembly. Now I have the universal joint axle, which is here. And this is the assembly there, which is the whole component. Yeah, okay, awesome. Now what we want to do is, in this particular window, for the universal joint, we want to rename it, and then we want to reorient the shape on this origin. So let's do that. So the first thing we want to do is we want to click on the face. Okay. Let's try to get it so that the Z All right, there we go. So sometimes it takes a while to get this to point in the right direction so that the Z-axis is pointing outward. Okay. Now, the goal is to take this and move it to the origin, right? And then use the anti-align to Z. Doesn't say to fix it. We just want to move it to the origin, which is over here. So let's go right click, move to origin, and then click on the axis. And the directions say to use anti-align Z. And let's just go to the triad or trimetric. So let's see. Yep, I think that's the way it's supposed to be aligned. Perfect. Excellent. That's what we want. Now it says to fix in place. All right. So let's just click on the object. And fix in place. There it is. Okay, so it did want us to fix it. So we're moving slowly, surely, making it happen. What's the next set of directions here? All right, I'll just drag these over here, show you what's going on. Navigate back to the main assembly. Select the replicate feature to instance the new sub-assembly, okay? And then it says to select the sub-assembly as the instance to replicate and choose match individual faces from the pull-down menu. So this is what I'm trying to replicate right here. It says select these three faces. All right, let's try it. I think I kind of understand what it's asking, so let's try it here. Main assembly here. There's a replicate option. So this one, replicate feature, where is that? There it is right there. So that's the replicate feature. Select it. We want to select the okay, so for instances, universal joint axle subassembly. This is it right here. Yeah. That's what I'm checking. Okay. Then, so I'm selecting this. Then it says match individual faces here. We want to go here. Mates to be matched. Oh, here we go. Here we go. Match individual face. It doesn't show it. So the directions say to match individual faces. And I think it's going to be match edges on faces. That's the verbiage changed. So I'm going to do that. And so it says, here we go. Let's pick the faces. I think it's going to be this face. Let's see. Okay, so I had to click on that. So I'm going to click on this here. And then click on this here. Let's see if I can make it happen here. I'm just going to get there and see this side. This side right here. Now it's not wanting me to select this particular face, and I don't know why. It looks like it might already be selected. There you go. Oh, there it is. Let's see what happens. I don't know. This one didn't turn gold. It's got like a bluish color. I don't know why. Mate to match. Now, missing mate to match. I'm not sure what this is here. Mate to be matched. I don't know what that is. So yes, there are challenges. This is not something that's straightforward even after reading directions. So I've chosen the replicate feature. There's an instance that I'm going to choose, and it's this universal joint axle. It's the name of mine. And then there is faces to be matched. It's this face here. So it's here. Here. And then on the back side. Okay. And then there's something here that I don't see in the directions. It says mate to be matched. And so the mate that I'm assuming we're matching is this one here. You see that one right there? So I'm going to click on it. And it's the same mate. It's a rigid mate on that surface. And there we go. We have it. So if I scroll down, let's see. I don't see it mentioning anything about the mate. But in this case, I had to choose that one. There you have it. So we're going to pause the video. We'll have a part two to this assignment via YouTube. So like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.